I'm Melissa, and this is The Book Break. Today, I'm at the Salt Lake City FanX Comic Convention, and I'm going to go talk to L.E. Modesitt and learn some little-known facts about him. Let's go. All right, just like I said, I am here with L.E. Modesitt, but I'm going to let you in on a little secret. So, L.E., I know that's not your full name. Tell our viewers, what is your name?
My full name is Leland Exton Modesitt Jr.
All right. But we can call you Lee. Okay, so we're going to call him Lee from now on because, you know, that's his name. Okay, so Lee, you've been writing a long time.
My first story was published in 1973.
Awesome. And let's, for our viewers that may not be familiar with you yet or are your hardcore fans, tell us a little bit more about what you write.
Pretty much everything in the science fiction and fantasy genre. I've written science fantasy, hard science fiction, what my publisher calls fantasy with rivets, which is basically, well, let's put it in a simple way. I did something when I wrote my first fantasy some 28 years ago, which at the time was absolutely new, and nobody knows that it's new because it's so basic. Everybody in every one of my fantasies has a real job and has to make a living.
Oh, like the real world.
Exactly. Well, I got tired of people going on quests with no visible means of support. Mm-hmm. Children went coming out. I mean, there's been a children's crusade in history. The only problem is nobody realizes that the kids all ended up dead or enslaved.
Yeah.
You have to have a visible means of support. And I just, maybe it's because I was originally trained as an economist, but I thought economics ought to be in fantasy, and it could still be fantasy.
Yeah. So how did you go from economics? Tell me a little bit more about what your day job used to be.
I've had a lot of day jobs. I was once a radio disc jockey.
Oh.
I've been a lifeguard. During the Vietnam era, I was a Navy helicopter search and rescue pilot.
Wow.
I then became what I was trained for, which was an industrial economist. The most boring job you will ever have. My job was to analyze the growth and sales patterns of compressed air, lubricators, regulators, and filters.
Yeah, that does sound boring. Not nearly as fun as sci-fi.
I lasted a year, decided that I could sell real estate. No, I was possibly the worst real estate agent in the history of Colorado. And then I got involved in politics. And that's another form of fantasy in a way. But I started writing research papers for a campaign. They asked me to go to Washington. Took, shall we say, a large cut in income to be a part-time teacher at Plymouth State University.
Oh, yeah.
And try to write full-time. Now, all the time I was in Washington, I was writing part-time, but it didn't make enough to pay the bills.
A lot of aspiring authors think as soon as they get their first book, that's it. They can just be done with their day jobs. Sounds like that wasn't your experience.
It took me 20 years of successfully selling stuff before I could afford to become a full writer, full-time writer.
Yeah. And with that, you have been continuing to write that entire time.
Yep.
How many books would you say you have out there?
I have 74 right now. There are two more on the way over the next year and a half, and I'm working on another.
And you just came out with a new one.
Right.
This one right here. Tell me about the Mage Fire War.
Mage Fire War, this is the 22nd book in the saga, but it's not a standard series in the sense that most of the books in it are either singletons or doubletons.
Oh.
And the stories take place across some 2,000 years.
Wow.
So, as long as you take the first book about a given character, the story will make perfect sense.
Yeah.
Now, if you read them all, you get a much richer picture of this universe.
Yeah.
But, I mean, the stories take place on 5 different continents across and with some 40 different countries and different forms of government.
So if I picked up the Mage Fire War, would that be okay if I hadn't read the others?
It would make sense to you. You'd lose a lot. Even the ones that are doubletons or this one trilogy, the story will stand on itself, but you wouldn't have as much background to appreciate it. I mean, I'd really recommend you pick up The Mongrel Mage, which is the first of 3 books about this character.
Yeah. So with some of your other books, do they all follow the same series, or you have...
No, I have actually 4 fantasy series.
Oh, okay.
There's The Imager Portfolio, The Spellsong Cycle, and The Corian Chronicles. The Spellsong Cycle all the protagonists are female, and it starts out with a middle-aged, divorced, with a lousy ex-husband, collegiate opera professor.
You know, I feel like some people could relate to that.
Well, I say that Anna is perhaps one of the most typical people, but her type is never in a fantasy novel. Middle-aged women who have families. And of course, the story starts when she loses a daughter, and she wishes she were anyplace else.
Yeah.
She gets that wish, and that's something you never want to do, because she ends up in a world where, yes, magic is governed by song, but it's also the most patriarchal, misogynistic country you'd ever want to be in.
Wow.
And if she can survive long enough to figure out how to convert her classical talents into magic, she'll probably be the most powerful person on the planet.
That sounds like a book I need to pick up and read. I'm excited. Well, thank you so much, Lee, for talking with me today. It's been great. And I gotta say, where can we find your books?
Pretty much everywhere. The big bookstores only will carry a few of them, but they're all available on Amazon, they're all available at Barnes & Noble, they're all available in ebook, and most of them, 50 out of the 74, are available in Audible books.
Perfect. Well, I'm definitely going to pick these up. Thank you so much for talking with me.
Well, thank you. I appreciate it.
Yes, thank you. And thank you for joining us on the Book Break. We'll see you next time.